to our first annual roast. I'm gonna bring your guy up tonight. So let's give it up for your guest of honor, Patrice O'Neal. Come on, your host, Rich Vos. Come on, folks.
Good evening, folks. Welcome. Thank you for coming out tonight for this Zero's Roast. Listen, I don't know, a lot of you may have never been to a roast before. There's going to be a lot of mean things said tonight. No one should take this personal, unless it's Eddie If. We're all here to have a good time, so just remember, it's all in fun. You know what sucks? Last night I was on NBC. Thank you. And tonight I'm fucking working this fire trap with this fucking loser. One second, like you're on network TV on top of the world, and the next second you're blowing a boring club owner for fucking spots. And I wish Sue Costello was here to confirm that. See, now you're already going ooh. There's no fucking oohing, okay? It's a fucking roast, alright? We're all friends. Some of us. You know how bad this fucking roast is when Colin Quinn is the biggest celebrity here. This guy's had more stabs in the business than fucking OJ, okay? Keith wrote that one. Two good friends of mine are here in the back, Opie and Anthony, a big hand for Opie and Anthony. This thing might run late tonight. You guys don't have to get up for work tomorrow, do you? I also have Manny and Esty here from the Comedy Cellar. And remember, now you're here tonight, you can't go back to the cellar.
I get it.
Okay, some of you won't get some of these because a lot of this shit's inside. You get it? All right, let's see who we don't have here tonight. You know, let's see. I gotta go through these notes. Some people we don't have. Oh, I don't see Lisa Lambrinelli here. Lisa will be in the vagina monologues, so we'll be playing a cunt. I'm not saying her material's not original, but her writing partners are Robin Hood and Michael Milken. You know, I'm fucking opening this bullshit right now, okay? Lisa says she's the female Don Rickles. The only difference is I fuck Don Rickles. Burger King delivery? Fucking smorgasbord molester. I don't see Judy Gold, or as I like to call her, Jew Alcinder. I also don't see Paul Mercurio or Dan Adaman. You know, those are the only two guys in the business with lips big enough to kiss Patrice's ass. Paul must be somewhere bringing down an empire right now. Fucking Hitler did less damage in Poland than Paul has done in his career. I don't see John Priest. John Priest has been in the business for 10 years. He has gone from shitty club comic to shitty club comic. I also also don't see Barry Katz in the room, which is good because we don't want anybody here that's hated more than Patrice. Carrie Kravis couldn't make it. She said she had to work in Vegas. I didn't know her brother owned a restaurant out there. And little Kev isn't here. He's in L.A. filming a movie. I think it's called Lawn Jockey. Oh, did he do a color joke?
Like that?
Fucking great. Look, I know, I'm a fucking mess. This fucking idiot would have wore a fucking suit, but he couldn't find one with a team logo on it. You know, it's funny when you roast somebody, it's because maybe it's their birthday, or they accomplished something in the business. Boy, you just don't like them. When I look at fucking Patrice, I think of five of the seven deadly sins. You know, I don't want to talk about his fucking weight, but his car has stretch marks. This fucking fat fuck should have his kitchen staple. Yeah. You ever see when black guys, when they drive and they lean to be cool, he does it to keep his car level. Patrice, his career is doing fucking well, man. You can't deny that. He was in a Spike Lee movie. He was in a Meg Ryan movie. My favorite piece of work is that movie he was in with Sigourney Weaver, where you couldn't see him through the mist. See how much people can't stand this fucking guy. Go to the Tough Crowd message board. Richard Speck is more liked amongst nurses. Is that a good one?
Can't be clever, just be stupid.
Okay. Thank you. Jesus, now you gotta sit next to him to kiss up? You fucking zero. Jesus, a year ago he would have been between Opie and Anthony. You belly whacking fucking douchebag. You fucking holy shit. Jesus Christ. And I don't want to smell your breath because it tastes like Dice's dick. He's a marshmallow.
You didn't even look back at him and say hello, you fucking asshole. Say hi.
I'll be who? Oh, no. I'm doing Stern this week. Fucking sellout cocksucker. He's a creep.
He
walked by O&A like people walk by DC Benny after one of DC shows. Hold on, let me see what we got first here. This is gonna be fun. Oh, you are so lucky to have me host this. I'm too fucking big for this bullshit. Hey, Singer, I'm open next week. Fucking Jeff can't even believe the job he has. You call him at work and he answers the phone. Three arts. Alright, first act, in a second, we're gonna bring Bobby Kelly to the stage. Bobby Kelly's career is so bad, Steve Byrne bumped him the other night. fucking Bobby perform, I wanted to quit the business. They're not all close. They're all follow that fucking Norton tire. Shut up. Bobby likes to eat, you can see. He sent me a fucking email with gravy on it. The other night, I know, I got fucking, I'm a mess here. I know. What do you call it? The other night, Bobby and Billy were at the cellar. Bobby and Billy Byrne, they were talking. I really didn't hear what they said, but I did hear Rutgers, Florida State, 750 after commission. And people would think it's as big and fucking pathetic as Bobby is that he's a lazy guy, but he's not. He sold more Dane Cook CDs after the show than any other band openers. Bobby's gonna come up here and make this podium look like a mic stand. A big hand for Bobby Kelly, folks.
Over at the Comedy Cellar, but they were sold out three shows, so we knew this fucking place was empty. Andy, that was for you. I have to have spots. Fuck off.
Give me that douchebag. I'm not
fucking Greg Giraldo. I need these.
So doesn't he, motherfucker.
Yeah, you're not that here, stupid.
You're not Greg because he does TV.
I did a show once.
That's the key word, once.
I really kiss. You know, Colin, you and Norton, you were all finished, and then Colin had to get a show and bring you all back on the fucking map. Go fuck yourself. Hoping Anthony's gone, he was going to jump out a window after sucking the transvestite cock. This douchebag is going to go coach his game, softball team. This fatso is going to fucking eat himself in a fucking coma, and you're not going to get a show. Fuck you and fuck you, Sam. Suck a dick.
Jeff, that was an audition for Tough Crowd. How do you do?
What's up, Jeff? Jason Steinberg's here. Jesus Christ, Jason. Isn't my career shitty enough for you to manage me? Why are you managed by you? I'm at the end. Come on. Did you get my tape? Clientele sucks. What are you doing? What the fuck is wrong with you? Jim Norton, fucking good friend of mine. He's fucking... just fucking... Jim, I love you, but you're awful. He's got a body... He looks like an angry thumb, doesn't he? The only guy I know that pees lying down. That's the only way you can get it in your mouth. Why are you fucking tan all the time? You go to the tanning salons, right?
No, I work on the road headlining and I play golf.
Are you golf naked, you fucking moron? Yeah. I shouldn't have cut that off. That was pretty funny, right? Look at your teeth. Listen, I actually, you know, we're here roasting and you know, everybody, we're all friends of Patrice, but actually I wanted to get a couple people that couldn't be on the roast that really, you know, the open micers and the people that this fucking moron has fucked with on a daily basis. I actually wanted to hear what they had to say, so I got my camera and I took a couple video things here. I want to show you, just to see what people really, really fucking think about this ass.
We go to the party tonight, it's your birthday. We go sip the card tonight, it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, it's not your birthday. We're trying to get in the club, down to the club.
You look like shit in that picture.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, yeah.
You know Patrice, right?
Unfortunately.
Nah. What do you think about Patrice's comedy? Do you think it's, you know,
trite?
Is that what you think?
That would be the word I'd use.
Really?
Yeah.
That's all right, man. I mean, if you like that kind of witty, I'm laughing at my shit type comedy, you know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm coming to black hugs, I want more, you know, and all that shit. He don't bring none of that.
He's in the black rooms.
Why is that?
He's scared.
He's scared of the black rooms?
Yeah, he tried to do it once. He went out and bought some outfits.
What do you think? Do you think he's up there? Do you think he's going to be up there with Colin and Pryor and you know, Eddie Murphy? Like, do you think he's that funny? Do you think his comedy is, like, amazing? Do you think he's one of the best comics?
He has the best pussy jokes I've ever seen in my life.
What do you think about the rest of his act?
That is his act.
Do you ever make fun of you personally?
Yeah.
Does that feel good?
It's embarrassing at times. I mean, he once said that I don't look like I wear nice panties.
The first time I met Patrice, I was really excited to meet him, and I introduced myself, and he wouldn't even touch me. He made his girlfriend touch me because I'm a white girl. He even said white girls have cooties.
Hey, Patrice, I'm a rare, you're elder. Like, you never fucking have a chance to be the good one me. But this guy fucking got something so bad. Thanks a lot for letting me call up the world today on your show. I know it's called Colin Quinn, tough crowd, but you never show. What do you want, a fucking filibuster?
I don't know, he's supposed to be all this and that, but he has to go to another country to get laid.
Patrice O'Neal? It's a big fucking closet case. Yeah, I really got nothing to say about Patrice, man. The only thing I can say about Patrice is he's like the comedy fucking gooch. He's a fucking big bully, and when he has a haircut, the back of his head looks like a fucking Shih Tzu puppy. That's all I got to say.
Fuck that nigga, yo. Fuck Patrice, yo. Fat motherfucker, yo. I wish that nigga run up on me, yo.
You know what else pisses me off about you? Your attitude in Montreal. The French. I love Jerry Lewis. They fucking hate you.
He's fucking vicious. He's a vicious fucking prick. He's just a sad, fat, bitter fucking man.
Emotionally cut off. Verbose.
You know, Patrice, the difference between this roast and other roasts is that most of the time roasts are done in the spirit of good fun. We're making fun of you, but we really don't mean it. The difference with this roast is everybody really hates you.
The fungus of the comic community, syphilis, gonorrhea, herpes, AIDS, all fucking festering together. He's the only thing funny about him is the fat fucking rolls on the back of his neck, the fucking sweat that comes off it, that is filled with Jesus buffalo wing sauce. He's an asshole, he's a cunt. He's got the likability of Josh Speer. He's the Uncle Tom on Colin Quinn's show. He's the dick he'll never find.
Is that Greg Rogel?
Big fat fucking cunt.
I think the roasts are pretty disrespectful and I don't really go into them and dig them. But Patrice, two words, fat nigger.
That was funny, right? All the white people went, oh. I got, you know, this is Patrice's roast. I just want to say one more thing. I did this other thing. Actually, I just wanted to show you this. A friend of mine, Steve Burns. You guys know Steve Burns? Real funny comic, right? You guys like Steve? Well, he actually borrowed my camera like a year ago to, he had to do an SNL audition, and you have to tape yourself doing characters, and he actually gave me the camera back and left the tape in the camera. And I thought you guys might get a kick out of it like I did 57 times at my house.
Get out of the way.
my name is Tim. I love TRL.
Hi, my name is Tammy. I'm from Westchester County. I request a kid bra, want to be cowboy because it kicks ass, and I'll say hi to my girlfriend back there, and then someone
shit! Oh, man. He left too. He's dead serious.
Good evening, I'm George Takei. You might remember me from my role as Captain Swordsman. Well, what have I been up to? What haven't I been up to? People come up to me and tell me to look speed, fire, and that's
motivational series, you will receive the best of Luther Vandross. Let me tell you something. That's good soul. Order now. Get your life back on track. I'm Bruce Lee, and it's time for you to kick ass. Without really kicking ass.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's funny.
Oh,
that's funny.
What does that mean? Who knows? But I just made you use your mind.
Can be your
Wait.
You have to see this last one. You guys might enjoy it. That's it. Patrice, congratulations on fucking absolutely nothing. Goodbye.
Hey, Bobby.
Bobby.
Hey.
All
right.
Did he get it? Did he get the tape?
Did he get
SNL?
He's hosting at the Cellar tonight.
Greg wrote that question last night. A big hand for Bobby Kelly. First time Bobby's been on stage without fucking a chair. Fucking Kyle Grooms is gonna use that as a TV credit. Yeah, we can't forget my manager Jason and Evan are here, so I gotta get them a little play. You ever think Evan looks at Jason and says, "Tell me about the rabbits"? Jason manages so many black comics, he shares an office with the ACLU. Jason is so fucking cheap, he charges commissions on callbacks. That's fucking funny, you fucks. That'll be Bobby. Another hand for Bobby Kelly. That was really funny. Bobby. Let's see who we got here next. We have this fucking lineup. We got a. DC, let's see. What's that? Turn the mic up? Can I turn the mic up? Masavia.
Okay.
Okay. Is Florentine his girlfriend here? Our next act, DC Benny. I tell you the truth, I was up the other night for like 2 hours trying to think of something to write about DC, and then I realized he's really not that interesting. A big hand for DC Benny.
Good to be here and catch a flailing hack. Another Steinberg big money gig. Esty's here. Esty? I think this. Oh, shit, that's funny. I'm going to get a call tomorrow. DC, can you do for me? Never again. Please call me to confirm. Look at this dais. What a fucking mook fest. Look at that shit, man. It's like a wine tasting at Mike Buschetti's. It's like a band from Star Wars with no instruments. Okay, let's skip to that. Boss, last comic stumbling. Oh, man. No, I'm sorry. But, nice suit. You look like Count Hakula. Yeah. Boss is happy. No, you're happy. You booked the teeth over today. That was good. Like, I don't give a shit who wins on that show. The best part is Boss actually gnaws his way to freedom from the house. So that's good. Yeah. Norton's here. His head looks like Lisa Lampanelli's clit. It's the only face to come with a circumcised neck. You talking fucking suppository. Sit around with Manny, act pro-Israel, and go home and jerk off to Mein Kampf. Patrice, you fucking sociopath. You're a train wreck on the Underground Railroad. When did your comedy become smart? I see you doing pussy fart jokes in the cellar. Okay, next day you're on Tough Crowd talking about your grassy knoll theory. You know? With your fucking cherry loafers. You look like G. Gordon Liddy's golf caddy. Like a 1930s comedy team, aimless and anchovy. You know, step and fetch it, you're fetching, fuck it.
Get to the poem.
All right, the poem's coming in. All right, dude. Okay, shut up. Fucking Andrew Dice nothing. Shit. Todd Barry's here. Todd Barry, good friend. Last time I saw a head that big, it was being dragged through the streets of Baghdad, beaten with slippers. Todd Barry's going to do a show at Luna. It's going to be an ironic bake sale. Hey, everybody, eat my brownies. Oh, yeah. Luna Lounge. You know why they call it Luna Lounge? Because once a blue moon, somebody fucking funny works there. Actually, Carabas in Greek means camel toe. She has a perfect body, though. Her body is perfect. There's one small birth defect. No mute button. She sounds like Carrie Hoffman being strangled doing Frank Sinatra. Oh, that's fucking funny. Thanks. The booker from Standup, what the next here? I thought Chevy Chase had no friends, but Jesus. Nick was going to wear a suit, but he opted for an apple with a parsley garnish. apple in the mouth, I forgot that. Sue Costello, the funniest thing to come out of her mouth is Chris Mazzilli's dick. Mazzilli in Italian means meal ticket. You're gonna get me. I don't give a fuck. Greg Giraffalo is here. Tough Crowd's teacher's pet.
Greg Giraffalo.
He's Spanish light. He's Puerto Rican. He makes Andrew Kennedy look like Felix Trinidad. Fucking writing. Greg actually invented this. I don't know if you know who that. That's cool. Yeah. No, Greg is actually Colombian. Hopefully the FARC rebels will come here from Bogota, take this fucking Civil War joke that he closes with, take it back there and fucking bury it. All right, that's too much. Vanessa Hollingshead hired Ross Bennett to write her roast material, which is good because it gave Sweetler a break from writing the rest of her act. Ross took the time out of his mystery novel, The Career That Never Was. Boston's actually opening a gift shop. In it, you will have the Ben Bailey action figure with an eyebrow that comes in three amazing positions. You can also get the Tony Woods Daylight Savings Time Narcoleptic Alarm Clock. There's no alarm, just a little voice going, "My fault, shorty." And it wakes you up in time to dodge your child support payments. It's great. Nice of Will to take a break from carrying Talent's jockstrap. Meanwhile, across town, Rob Stapleton is doing his cover version of Tracy Morgan's corn kernel in my shit joke. Crowd is very discerning. Colin Quinn, host of Tough Crowd, which has been touted as this year's Seinfeld because it's also a show about nothing. he has an entire career based on a blue-collar accent, manufactured outrage, a couple affected tics, and Eddie F's haircut. alternate names for the show, M. Night Shyamalan's Unwatchable. Weekend Upchuck, Manny in the Middle, Hot Air Little Dicks, and Uncle Tom's. Everyone is using Subway fare cards, which is good because now. I fucked that up. Everyone's using Subway fare cards, which makes Keith Robinson the only token still working. Some enemies tonight. Old Kevin Brennan. Kevin Brennan's personality should have a chalk outline surrounding it. This morning at breakfast, I opened a box of Lucky Charms. Billy Burr jumped out. Billy Burr, also known as Carrot Flop. I think that's it, man. You guys have been great.
DC, baby, how fun. Jesus. What's that? I'm a fucking mother. DC, baby, very funny. Jesus. He's burned the only last bridge we had in this business, the fucking cellar. Fuck, where is Nick? Nick's not here. You got him on stand-up? He is fucking gay. He sweats cum. What's that? All right, our next act coming to the stage. Let's have a big hand for Vanessa Hollingshead. Vanessa Hollingshead.
Teaches me a lesson to never buy your teeth over the internet. I'm really moved by at tonight's gathering. It wasn't too long ago that in order to get this many white people to show up for an evening featuring a black man, it either involved tap dancing or lynching. Would have had DC help me out, but he did lack some wit. I love you guys. I usually feel bad when a man doesn't want to have sex with me, but tonight I would feel lucky. I have to admit I'm a little uncomfortable doing this. Patrice and I don't know each other that well. But then again, why would we? I'm not a prostitute. I'll never forget the first time I saw Patrice. I had the same thought most women have. If he dies, I could use his coat to reupholster my sofa. It's good to see Jim Norton tonight. You know, Jim, for a guy who likes women to shit in his mouth, my breath was surprisingly fresh.
Exercise is when he attempts to wipe his own ass.
seems such a fucking bitch, man.
Until after Lucia and I got separated. He was saying, oh, yes, oh, baby, I can tear your ass up. We can have so much fun. For the record, I'd rather have Todd Lynn hit me in the cunt with a baseball bat. Spark between us, because come on, you and Lucian have so much in common. You know, the only difference between you and Lucian is that Lucian can see his own dick.
Star attraction. Jim Davis here, how you doing? What comedy club will you be spinning at this weekend? Just turn on the fucking weather channel to see. Who the fuck? Keith's not here?
Nope.
I got all these brothers here. Alright, who are we gonna bring up next then if Keith's not fucking here? Oh shit. It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure bringing up our next act. Let me tell you something about Colin. Where's Colin? You know, Colin's the only person that sounds better on a cell phone. All right. Listen, I fucking killed up front. I did my fucking job. Big hand for Colin Quinn.
Great to be here. Rich Vos, who I've known when none of you guys were even in the business, I knew Rich by his old nickname, White Maurice. He, how can I describe Rich? Dane Cook without the artistic integrity. That wouldn't be too funny at Boston, because half you motherfuckers think he's a genius. Now listen, Jesus Christ, wash ups here than Lacey Peterson and her baby. Oh, Jesus Christ. Please, calm down, even though you guys hated that joke and thought it was in bad taste. Norton thought it was like really hip and the boss is, it's funny watching the boss with all these always good friends. I watched like six generations of this with Vos. Does it bother you to catch fire after 25 years of comedy? It's really kind of anticlimactic at this point. I hope you get that sitcom deal once. I'll tell you though, he's got a lot of different friends, but he's been loyal to his act this whole time. Jim Norton. Jim Norton is, he's actually become quite a, he's a comic, he's a headliner too. He says he can do an hour. If you count 15 minutes of telling dummies with mullets that their First Amendment rights are being violated because he can't make a Christopher Reed joke on Letterman. Poor fellows would be proud of that. Patrice, I can barely say, it's really sad. I'm really old. I know that I'm really too old and too big to be at this thing. I understand that. The only reason I came is because Patrice really was so pathetic. His friend came up to me and was like, look, please show up. And I knew I'd be the only semi-name here. All right, anyway. I know, right now, everyone's going, I'm kind of a name. That was last year. The heat is off. Let me just talk to Patrice. Let me talk about the man that I really am an old man. Look at this. I can barely fucking see. Well, okay. I'll start with some advice because he's actually headlining probably, you know, because a headliner has to leave the audience with that feeling in their stomach. And let me just give you a little advice. Walking a room is not crowd work. Threatening to rape a white girl in front of her parents is not a closing bit. Now, wearing a sterling silver microphone around your neck, if it was white given gold, to you by somebody, white gold, white gold, sorry. I can see your priorities are in order for you. You're right, we really do stereotype. Anyway, I'm sorry, wait.
Put this in
a way. Wearing a white gold microphone around your neck is, it's kind of pathetic if somebody gives it to you like it is a award or something, but when you buy it for yourself, it's almost not to be made fun of. It's that's true. It is better than Nick's comedy tragedy tattoo. I'm sorry. It's kind of hard. It's the kind of thing that you're embarrassed to even make fun of, like when Adam Ferrara does a bit to you while you're off stage. It's good to be here at Boston Comedy Club. This is the funniest. This is the funniest halfway house residence I've ever been to. This club's important because you know what? The comics at Dangerfields have to have some place to look down on. This is my man Billy Burr. He's gone through quite a career change writing-wise. No, in the past year he's gone through a metamorphosis. He took the Y off his name, so it's Bill Burr. Get off of that. You actually removed the letter and you still wrote more than Vos last year. So. Oh, God. I'm sorry. And let me tell you something. I fucking love today's man too, so good for you. Yesterday's man. What was I going to say? Patrice is you know, as we all know, he's also a, he's a very, what do you do? He's a hard worker. He wakes up every day and then calls up everybody he knows until he finds the one kind of new friend that'll call him a genius and talks to him for 3 hours. You know, the thing is, Patrice is like a true, he truly is a brilliant comic because he can never hear the laughter and he can never see the light. And, but I love your spontaneousness on stage. That's what I really love. No, really. He has new material every night. By new material, I mean he laughs at different places in the same jokes. As if he's hitting for the first time. Steve Burns, by the way, but after that fucking skewering film, I honestly think we should have some kind of vote and just really, nobody should ever let Steve work anywhere again. We should have back to the fucking home. No, I would have said this before the film, actually. He's half Irish, he's the only Asian comic in the country, and he still needs another hook to be funny. Patrice, I like the fact that you, well, first of all, what's more charming, because we all know Patrice has a certain charm, that when you don't know Patrice that well, and he gives you that look where he's pretending to appreciate what you're saying to him, but really he's just, you know, he's just recording it for further abuse to tell everybody what an asshole you are. Okay, what was I going to say? Well, I'll say one thing about Patrice. I think the number on his shirt says it all tonight. More of a verb, really, than a number. Thank you, thank you.
Eight.
You showed it to everybody and it still barely got a laugh. Jesus Christ, this could be a nightmare for me trying to get off. Hold on.
Don't worry, I'm sure you'll get canceled in a second.
You know what? This actually is a very sentimental night for me. Because this is what comedy was. So I was in the golden era of comedy. And, you know, Vos was an MC, just like he is tonight. So. No, I think we're going to close it up. Thank you very much.
Colin Quinn, folks.